Hey there, and welcome to Kansas Smitty's. We're thrilled to be here tonight with a great band, but I'm going to tell you about that in a second. I just want to say that this is our third full week of, well, this is our third week of five nights a week of live jazz here from Memrise. And we want to actually give a shout out to the Memrise International Language Symposium Organizational Congregational Meeting of Great Minds. I added some extra words there, but you know, you know who you are if you're in that crew. We love being here at Memrise, and it's just great. It gives us a chance to do this, so it's really fun. Before we start the music tonight, I just want to remind you that we can't do this without your support. There are two links below this video, one to our Patreon page and one to a donation link where you can support the music the way you choose. If you join the Patreon at the £10 a month tier, you get access to the full archive of Smitty's concerts. So you can just put this on at home in the background, or you can check it out again if there was something that really tickled your fancy, or you just laughed at a funny face that Alec made. And you can just watch that on loop if you want. We're going to jump into this album tonight. It's an interesting one. It's Duke Ellington and John Coltrane in the studio together, 1963 and 62, right? 1962. And it's an interesting one from that that era, because you would never put those two together, and it was kind of a ploy from the record company to make something happen. And it produces these really amazing results where you have Duke Ellington's kind of block chord style and obviously his incredible compositions, and then you have Coltrane kind of soaring over the top. And that's what we're going to have tonight. So without further ado, I'm going to give you over to Alec Harper, Deschanel Gordon, Ferg Ireland, and Will Cleasby. This is Duke Ellington and John Coltrane.
Thank you. Thanks very much. Thanks a lot. Thank you. Thanks. Who am I speaking to here, Das? Where am I looking? Ollie, how you doing? All right, guys at home. All right, guys here, how you all doing? Yeah. Amazing to see so many people behind me, in front of me. We've got a little in the round thing going on. So hopefully everyone can hear all right. As Giacomo mentioned, we're doing John Coltrane, Duke Ellington. It's a fantastic album. And it's been interesting for us to learn it, hasn't it? Because there's been some tunes you know really well. They're sort of kind of quite iconic, like the one we just heard in a sentimental mood. And there's some we don't know so well. But I think you might know the next one. This one is called Take the Coltrane. Thanks a lot. Thank you. Give it up for Will Cleasby on the drums. Will Cleasby on the drums, everyone. Give it up for Deschanel Gordon on the piano. Yeah. Give it up for the rock behind it all, Mr. Ferg Island on the double bass, everyone. That was, of course, Take the Coltrane, written by Mr. Duke Ellington. Going to move on now with the one tune on the record, which is written by Mr. John Coltrane. The man, the legend, and it's called Big Nick. We hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
How about it for Alec Harper on the tenor saxophone, Will Cleasby on the drums, Deschanel Gordon on the piano, Ferg on the bass. Sounds absolutely amazing, guys. Sounds incredible. This is a project that we never thought we'd undertake at Smitty's, of kind of digging into albums of the past. But it's a really fun way for us to identify with our heroes, you know, because these albums aren't just the best-selling albums of best-selling jazz albums of all time that we just picked off of Google. They're albums that mean something to us. So, you know, this is. I know I've talked to Will a lot about this album. It's an interesting one because there are two different rhythm sections, because obviously it's this meeting of these two giants, but neither one of them wanted to leave their teams at home. So you have half the tracks with Ellington's rhythm section and half the tracks with Coltrane's rhythm section, and they play completely differently, especially behind somebody like Coltrane, who's kind of, you know, tearing the music apart from every possible angle. So it's incredible to hear you guys doing that. I'm absolutely loving it. And we're going to continue. We have a whole half of the album to go, but I want to remind you to check out the links below this video to find out how you can support what Kansas Smitty's is doing. We have 5 nights of live music a week, Tuesday to Saturday, which you can watch on Facebook and YouTube. You can also join the studio audience to be like these wonderful, beautiful people. Are you having a good time? If you want to do that, check the link tree on our Instagram page, and you can just click on become or be part of the studio audience. We have a great program for November that we're going to be launching this week. A lot of great albums and a lot of great bands, and a few new people coming into I call our bands a musical Noah's Ark, because we have 2 bass players, we have 2 drummers, we have 2 piano players. We only have 1 Alec Harper, but that's probably. I'm going to give you back to the band now. Hope you enjoy the rest of this great album, Duke Ellington and John Coltrane.
We're going to move on now with a track. This one's also by Ellington, and it's called Stevie. Stevie. All right, give it up for Deschanel Gordon on the piano. Give it up for Mr. Ferg Island on the double bass. Beautiful. Mr. Will Cleasby on the drums. We're going to move on now with a beautiful ballad. This one's written by a very close friend and composer to Mr. Duke Ellington. In fact, very often when you hear a tune that's composed by Duke Ellington, it was probably written by Billy Strayhorn. Is that right? A lot of them, at least, so they're kind of interchangeable, but a brilliant composer. This is Billy Strayhorn's My Little Brown Book.
Thank you.
All right, thank you very much. Thanks a lot. Just want to say, anyone who's at home and is thinking, wow, it looks like it's loads of fun there, we'd like to come. Well, you can, if you didn't already know that. The studio audience has been going a little while now, and we've got a little capacity, but if you sign up early enough, you're more than welcome. We'd love to have you here. It's making such a huge difference to us to both be playing to people at home and to have people in the audience here. So keep supporting in any way you can, and obviously, what Giacomo said, please help us out with some donations if you like what you're listening to tonight. We're going to move on now with another quite famous Duke Ellington song, which I played a lot in the last couple of years, and it's called Angelica. It's also got the name Purple Gazelle. So choose whichever you prefer. Purple Gazelle?
Yeah.
We'll take votes at the end, after the raffle. So yeah, this one is called Angelica. Thanks. Thank you.
Purple Gazelle is my preferred title, I have to say. What a great band tonight. We have a great schedule coming up the rest of this week. Just want to tell you a few of the highlights. Tomorrow night we have Kit Downs coming in to play with Will Sash and a drummer called Martin France. And on Thursday, Joe Webb's going to be playing some of the music of Ahmad Jamal with a great drummer called Jason Brown, who's in London right now. And on Friday, we have the very sad sad duty of sending Darcy O'Connor, our favorite producer and top Smitty's employee of all time, gold medal award, is going back to Australia. So we're going to send him off with we programmed a going away concert with the whole Kansas Smitty's band, just for him. He's gonna work through it, which is crazy, right? So check all that out. We really appreciate you tuning in. And thank you so much to our studio audience here. Thank you all for being in the room. You can't imagine how much of a difference it makes for the band to have your energy going into the, you know, into the music. So it's much appreciated. And to you at home, we hugely appreciate your support as well. And we hope to see you soon and later this week. Remember to check those links that I mentioned before below this video to find out how you can support Kansas Smitty's. This last tune is called The Feeling of Jazz. You've been listening to the music of Duke Ellington and John Coltrane, played by Alec Harper on the tenor saxophone. Give it up for him. Deschanel Gordon on the piano. Ferg Ireland on the double bass. And that's Will Cleasby on the drums. This is The Feeling of Jazz.